Today, we are talking appraisal gaps. What is an appraisal gap, and should you even consider it? Hi, I'm Daphne Bousquet with Fayette and Peachtree City Homes and Lifestyles for eXp Realty. So in this market, an appraisal gap is more and more the norm if you want to buy a house and you are not paying cash. And let's face it, that is most of us. So what is an appraisal gap? An appraisal gap is where a buyer guarantees to pay above the appraised value of a house. Whether you put down 3.5% or 5% or 20%, a lender will only lend you on that remaining amount of the appraised value of that house. So if you are buying a house that is more expensive than the appraised value, there is an appraisal gap. And then your choices are to either lower the purchase price, which a lot of sellers are not willing to do if they have 10, 20 offers on a house, or you pay the gap. You pay the difference between the appraised value and the sales price. When you're in a hot market, which we are in right now, appraisals generally lag the purchase price, which causes appraisals to come in low. When inventory is low, a lot of times in this market, there are 10 or more buyers for each house. Now, that obviously drives up the purchase price well above appraisal. So, isn't it insane to be paying above the appraised value of a house? Let's talk about that. It really depends on whether you think we are in a housing bubble or not. And you can see my thoughts on that matter in the video below and linked up there. There are 78 million millennials right now, representing 31% of the population. In comparison, baby boomers at their height only had 27% of the population. 70% of these millennials have indicated that they are planning on buying a house in the next 3 years. That adds 50 million buyers to the market. And according to the National Association of Realtors, 2021 and 2022 will be peak buying years for these millennials. According to the National Association of Mortgage Bankers, 45% of all mortgage applications are now by millennials. With facts like these, it doesn't look like demand for housing is going to slow down anytime soon. And what is that going to do to home prices? According to the Home Buyers Institute, prices are going to continue to rise all of 2021 and well into 2022. And if home prices are going to continue to rise by 5 to 10% in 2021 and 2022, does an appraisal gap guarantee make sense? Let's do the math. Say you are buying a house that is listed at $250,000. Now here in Fayette County, Georgia, that is low end of the market, and there is a lot of competition for houses like these, including from cash buyers. You offer $265,000, which is 6% over the list price, with a $15,000 appraisal gap guarantee. Congratulations, you won the house. Now the appraisal comes in and it appraises only at $255,000. So you have to come up with an extra $10,000 at closing. Is that a smart idea? Let's do the math. Let's be conservative and say that home values are going to increase by 3% over the next 2 years. That means that your $265,000 house will be worth $270,529 in 2 years. That sounds like it is well worth the $10,000 in appraisal gap if you're planning on staying in your house for at least 2 years. If the house increases in value by 5% over the next 2 years, the value would be $281,137. Definitely worth the $10,000 appraisal gap. If you are planning on staying in your house for a few years and are expecting home values to continue to rise, it makes sense to pay an appraisal gap. Even if the housing market is not quite as hot as it is right now. However, you have to do the math. It may not make sense in every single situation, and I do not advocate a blanket appraisal gap guarantee. Talk to your realtor. Make an offer that makes sense for you. But do not reject an appraisal gap guarantee out of hand. Do the math and get your house while interest rates are still low. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe to this channel. New videos come out every Monday, so I'll see you next week.